All right, welcome to the Week 12 lab. This is going to be a fun lab. We'll have two labs this week, and this one is about flexible cats. Yep, look at these pictures. Oh my God. We have to build a flexible website, so I thought we would make it about flexible cats. This is our goal. You want the images to fit. You want them to float around the text. You want this sidebar to float. It's actually, if you look at your index, I downloaded this from WordPress, so you'll see a lot of tags here that you don't recognize, but you'll also see some you do. Up to here, I think all of this is clear and easy. You know the aside tag, you know the div tags. You probably don't know the form tag or the label tag, but that's okay. You'll learn them. They're part of HTML5. And the rest of this, I think you know. Let's see what it looks like. I'm going to open it with my live server. Have you installed that extension yet? It's so handy. Here it is. So I can see right away, this is way too big, that header image, but it needs to be responsive. That's our task today. So what happens when I make it smaller? Oof, oof, bad things, right? Nothing good. We need for this area to jump below or above. And we can take care of all of that with our floats and our viewport. Looks like we need to link these images too. So let's take a peek at the tag tree, the inspect tool. And the first thing I'm gonna look for is whatever container it is that holds everything. So that might be the page, yep. And I can see that that's got a width of 960, yep. That makes me think that this container here, let's see, yep, there's a container there. What's that container? Is that the, it's inside the page, it's probably the sidebar, and yep, there it is, 324px, and what about this one? That looks like it's the primary content area, and content area, where is that? Right there, and that is 636. So you know that with absolute measurements like this, these are absolute, we need to make them relative. The easiest thing to do is going to be to change all of these widths to percentages. So we'll do that, and we'll link these images, we'll take care of the viewport tag and the floats, and then everything will be done, right? This is just a little practice exercise on how to turn a website into a responsive site. So let's go to the next video and do all that work.